Good evening. In the last lecture, we have seen some programs on different loops available in C programming language, like some programs on for loop, while loop, and do while loop. Today, we are going to study about the nested loops in C programming language. What do you mean by nesting of loop? When one loop is completely embedded in another loop, then it is called as nesting of loop. For example, if you see this code here, there are two for loops, for loop with I and the for loop with j. This for loop with j is completely embedded, written inside the outer for loop, right? So this type of writing one loop inside another loop is called as nesting of loop. In case of nested loops, for every value of I in this example, for every value of I, the inner for loop where j goes from 1 to 2. So, for every value of I, the inner for loop execution is completely done. It means when I is 1, j will go from 1 to 2. So, now, we will see the execution of this code. How many times this inner code gets executed? That is these two lines of statement. That is sum equal to I plus j and the printf statement. How many times these two lines of code gets executed? For every value of I, the j loop is completely executed. It means two times it gets executed. Because j is initialized to 1 and it is less than or equal to 2. It means at least two times this loop gets executed. I loop is also is going from 1 to 2. It means this nested loop execution execute the code of inner for loop 4 times 2 by 2 here, right? Now when I value is 1, j value is also 1 and both the conditions are true, then compiler allows us to execute the two line statements, that is sum equal to I plus j, and here it becomes 1 plus 1 is 2 in sum. It prints the values of I, j and sum. That is 1, 1 and sum is 2. From here, it goes back to check the condition of inner for loop. Before that, increments the j value by 1. Now, j value becomes 2 and then it check the condition. J is now 2 and the condition is true. It means that it again allows us to execute the code. Sum equal to I plus j. Now, I is 1 and j is 2. Sum becomes 3. So, this printf statement will be going to print the message on the screen. I is 1, j is 2 and sum is 3. Again, it goes back to increment the value of j here. J becomes 3 and the inner condition becomes false. When inner condition becomes false, the compiler goes to increment the outer for loop I plus plus, right? So, here I gets incremented by 1, I value becomes 2. For I value becomes 2, the condition is true, it allows us to enter into the internal for loop. And again, here j becomes 1. And the sum goes to 2 plus 1, that is 3. I value is 2, j value is 1. And it prints that I is 2, j is 1 and sum is 3. Again, internally j gets incremented by 1. And the condition is again true, j becomes 2 and the condition is true. Now the sum becomes 2 plus 2, that is 4. In the printf statement, it will print I value as 2, j value as 2 and sum is 4. Again, it increments the j value internally. Now it j value becomes 3. When j value becomes 3, the inner condition becomes false and it exits from inner for loop and goes to the outer for loop to increment the value of I. Now here I value becomes 3 this time and the condition is also false. It means that now it stops the execution of the for loop. It means that the execution of the nested loops stops only when the outer condition becomes false. Outer loop condition becomes false. So, this way the nested loop works in C programming language. We can use this nested loops in implementation of pattern programming as well as in implementation of matrix programming where we perform the addition of two matrices, subtraction, multiplication and division that we are going to study about in the chapter arrays. Now we'll see the first program using the nested loops concept. A question may be asked for 10 marks in the exam, like write a program to print the following pattern of stars. Here if you see, a pattern of star is given to you. On the first row there is only one star, on the second row there are two stars, on the third row there are three stars, on the fourth row there are four stars, and the fifth row there are five stars. Now if you consider this diagram as a matrix where there are five rows and five columns, correct, and the logic that we get from this image is on every row the number of stars are increasing by one. So we'll take two for loops to implement this program. So we'll write the code for this image pattern of stars. So we'll declare the header files like this in the C program, that is hash include str.h, hash include conio.h, then void main. We open the program here by opening curly bracket. We'll declare two variables, one for row and one for column. That is I is for rows and j is for columns. We need only two for loops to implement this program. Clear screen, will clear the screen. In the outer for loop, we specify the number of rows. And in the diagram, in the given diagram, there are five rows. So we'll run a loop in such a way that I value will start with 1 and it goes till 5, which indicates there are 5 rows, right? And every time I gets incremented by 1. This is our outer for loop. Inside the outer for loop, we'll write another for loop which actually prints the stars on that row. So that loop is J loop. We'll start J equal to 1. But how many stars we want in on every row? That is the number of the row number, number of stars equals to the row number, correct? So we write the condition in such a way that it matches and it prints that many number of stars on that particular row. So if you see, if you are on the first row, there is only one star, correct? So we'll write a condition in such a way that it satisfies this rule of incrementing star by one on every row. So we'll write a condition j less than equal to I semicolon j plus plus, and inside this inner for loop we'll write a printf statement which print one star inside it. After completing inner for loop, to go to the next row we'll use printf slash n, that is a line break statement which help us to go to the next row. And this close the outer for loop. Get stage will hold the output somewhere on the screen, and this curly bracket stop the execution of the program. Now we'll see the handle of this program, how it will going to print by the two nested for loop the pattern, required pattern. Now consider here I value is 1. Here it check the condition I less than equal to 5, that is true now. So it enters into the inner for loop where the j loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 1, j plus plus, because coming i value is 1. So this loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 1, j plus plus. It means that this loop will going to execute at least once. So if it execute at least once, it will going to print one star on that particular row. It means that we are on the first row, this star gets printed by that for loop. Okay. After printing the star, it goes back to increment the value of j. Now j becomes 2, and the condition, if you check it here, 2 is not less than 1, because I value was 1 in the previous iteration, and j value becomes 2 and the condition becomes false. It means that on the first row it only prints one star and stops the execution of the inner for loop. After completing inner for loop, the next printf line will go to the next line. The cursor will be shifted to the next line. It means we are on the second row here, correct? The cursor is on the second row. From this line it goes back to increment the value of I. Now I becomes 2, it means you are on the second row. Condition is, if you check it into the first for loop, the condition is also true. It means it allows us to print the star on the second row. The inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 2, because in this step j I value is now 2. J j less than equal to 2, j plus plus. It means that this for loop will going to execute 2 times. When it executes first time, it will print 1 star here. When it executes second time, it will print the next star on the same row, second row, correct? So when j value becomes 3, it stops the execution of the inner for loop. This printf line will shift the cursor to the third row. Here is your cursor, say on the third row, correct? Then I becomes 3. From here it goes to I plus plus. It means I becomes 3, and again it checks the condition. Condition is true. The inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 3, j plus plus. This time this for loop will going to execute 3 times, and this printf statement will print 3 stars on the third row. After printing the third star, j becomes 4 and it stops the execution of the inner for loop. This printf line will shift the cursor to the fourth row. It means we are on the fourth row. I is incremented by 1, I becomes 4, and again the condition is true. It means we are on the fourth row. The inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 4, j plus plus. In this script, it prints 4 stars on the fourth row. After completing fourth star on fourth row, it exits from the inner for loop and go to the next line by the next printf statement slash n, correct? From here, it again increments the value of I. Now, value of I becomes 5, and again the condition is true. This inner for loop becomes j equal to 1, j less than equal to 5, j plus plus. This time, on the fifth row, it prints 5 stars here like this, okay? After printing the fifth star, j becomes 6, and it stops the execution of the inner for loop. This printf line will shift the cursor to the sixth row, and from here it goes to increment the value of I. When I value becomes 6, it stops the execution of the loop because the condition becomes false here. 6 is not less than equal to 5. When outer condition becomes false, it stops the execution of this entire nested for loop and stop printing the pattern of stars. Now if you see, when you execute this code, it actually generated a pattern of star like this. Left justified right triangle of stars. So like this, any pattern may be asked in the examination for 10 marks. If you have any doubt in the program, please ask me. You can write your question into the chat room. Any question, please type your question into the chat room. If you do not have any questions, please write no doubt. Okay, there are no doubts, I think, because there is no response from the student. So, thank you for watching this video.